You stay in the car, you keep your nose out of those packages, they're not for you. He searched through every cupboard and drawer in the apartment trying to find out what I got for him. But this Christmas, he will not succeed.
Well, what do you think?
How much is it again?
$75. I have some more over here that are less expensive, and you really can't tell the difference.
No, you can tell. He used to have one just like it.
It is a beautiful gift.
Okay. Okay, I'll buy it.
Tone in your voice. You think I'm being cheap.
No, I think there's nothing wrong with being frugal, Ray. And if you can't afford to buy presents, well, getting them for opening a bank account is a viable, if not inventive, alternative.
But you think that I can't afford it. You just think I'm being cheap. That's what you think.
I think nothing of the sort. And where are we off to?
Right here, savings and loan.
Ah, of course.
Oh, you see? You see? That's the tone I'm talking about. You see that tone?
What tone?
That tone. You see?
You can't see a tone, Ray. No, but this young man did.
Right now, every kid that sits on my lap, I get $2.
Yep.
I can go through 40 kids an hour.
Oh, I can do 50.
Bull, no one can do 50 and live.
Look, it's not a difficult question, okay? Where were you at 12 o'clock today?
Hey, man, I got three L's to put me in the department store.
Yeah, one of those L's said you went out for about 20 minutes.
Yeah, well, he's a lying rat bastard.
Okay, line up, you six. This way. Not you. What are you waiting for? Christmas? Move it. Yeah, Merry Christmas to you two. Out the door.
We're not interested in how fluffy his beard was. That's him. That's the sixth Santa you pointed to. Can we focus a little here?
He had a twinkle in his eye.
I don't understand the problem here. Some citizen pulls the alarm and ran away.
But ask yourself who, Ray. All the businesses above were closed. All the employees and patrons were under guard on the bank floor. Anyone coming in would have been noticed by the Wheelman. After they took over that building, only four people had access to that hallway.
So what are you saying? One of the robbers pulled the alarm?
Yes.
That's ridiculous.
About as ridiculous as going to a robbery with an unloaded shotgun.
I'll tell you, for a second there, Fraser, I thought I was...
Why would a guy pull the trigger of a gun he knew was unloaded?
Seems improbable, doesn't it?
Yes. You know, the wheel man, he knew exactly when the bag man was behind the counter. If he pulled the alarm, they panic. He comes running in. The bag man is trapped behind the counter. He throws the bag to the wheel man, who throws him back the gun.
Clever, isn't it?
Hey, in the heat of the moment, I'd take a gun over a bag any day. The whole thing's a double cross.
Detective Vecchio, Yui, Louie, join me for some eggnog. The last half hour, I've gotten calls from seven department stores, the Salvation Army, two parade officials, and the director of a children's pageant. This was further augmented by calls from four city councilmen, the deputy mayor, and the police commission. We're all curious as to why we're detaining all the Santa Clauses in the city on Christmas Eve. The police commission was especially irked since his daughter was sitting on Santa's knee in a department store when said Santa was cuffed and thrown into a paddy wagon. In our zeal to solve this case, I can't help but wonder if we haven't been, I don't know, how do you say it? Excessively stupid?
Detective Huey and I have a theory, sir.
Oh, this I'd like to hear.
See, we believe that the perpetrators were dressed in Santa Claus suits in order to facilitate their getaway by blending into the crowd.
And that people don't usually notice armed men fleeing a crime scene in big red suits.
Actually, they could even have had jobs in local department stores, sir. I mean, that would be the perfect cover.
This is your theory?
Yes, sir.
It's not our only theory.
We have others, sir.
Detective Vecchio, do you have a theory?
Yes, sir, but actually it's Constable Fraser's theory, sir.
Oh, really?
Good afternoon, Lieutenant.
Oh, Merry Christmas, Constable. I assume you're working on some kind of a North Pole connection?
No, sir. And actually, it's a misconception that the North Pole is in Canada, sir. Its ownership has been in dispute ever since Admiral Perry planted a flag there in 1909, a fact that in itself is in dispute, since many believe it was Matthew Henson, an African-American, who first discovered it.
Constable Fraser and I believe that the wheelman pulled the alarm in order to throw the whole situation into chaos, thus double-crossing his partners.
Oh, sure. Sure, one of the robbers pulled the alarm himself.
Yes, sir.
And we have a witness who saw the wheelman without his beard. We got him out there going over the mugshots right now. If the wheelman's in there, he's pretty much in our pocket, sir.
All right. Vecchio, you get the wheelman. Yui and Louie, you get the other three.
Yes, sir.
Which one of your flatfoots took my reindeer?
I looked. He's not in there.
Look one more time.
I already did.
Look, kid, whoever this guy is, he's no first timer. If he's done this before, odds are 100 to 1 he's right there in front of you. Maybe he looks a little different, but he's there, so I need you to look again.
He's not in there.
Look, kid, I'm having a good day, okay? It's Christmas Eve. I am filled with love for my fellow man, but I swear to God, if you don't look again, I'm gonna slap you upside the head.
Ray, may I? Del. Why don't you just describe to us the man you saw?
I didn't get a good look.
The guy was 3 inches from your face. It doesn't get any better than that.
Ray, maybe Del is just afraid of what will happen if he identifies this man.
Well, maybe Del should be afraid of what will happen if he doesn't. Look, kid, you're not the only one who saw a face. This guy was so close to you, he could count your pores. How hard do you think it'll be for him to find out where you live? You put the finger on this guy and we can protect you, but if you don't...
We'll still protect you.
Maybe he will, but I won't, and no other cop will either.
You really were touched by the spirit of Christmas.
Kid's making a big mistake. What's that?
It's a gift.
I don't know. Maybe I was too hard on him.
Yes.
Hey, guys. They pulled a palm print off the countertop. Your bag man is Robert L. Flanagan. FBI have him linked to 6 bank jobs with James and Cameron Donnelly.
No kidding.
Is that significant?
Well, the Donnellys are something of a local legend around here.
They had a partner named Nick Stilitis. Rumor had it he skimmed a small amount of money from them. He took off to Mexico. The Federales found him in bite-sized pieces in the Sea of Cortez.
There's only 2 rules written in the pavement in this town. You don't steal from the mob and you don't cross the Donnellys.
I think I should return this gift.
Oh, that's good, Benny. We only have a couple hours to find a wheelman before they turn him into fish food and you're delivering Christmas presents.
Thank you, Ray.
Hi, Del.
Hi.
Came looking for your dad. He wasn't home.
Yeah.
But you tell him Jimmy Donnelly dropped by, will you? Tell him I expect to meet him tomorrow at the distillery as planned. Will you do that for me?
If I see him, yeah.
That's a good boy.
Hi, Del. You left this at the station.
Thanks.
I'll give you a hand with this. William Porter. Is that your father?
Yeah.
A writer, is he?
Not really.
My father was quite the writer.
Professional?
No. A Mountie. But he kept journals. He must have filled up almost 100. You know, it's odd. We never really spent all that much time together when I was young, so it's only recently through his writing that I feel as though I've gotten to know him.
Is he dead?
Yes.
Sorry.
You know, I've always thought it was the bravest thing a man could do. Writing down his innermost feelings so that any stranger could read them.
Yeah, well, I'm the only stranger I've read any of these.
Mind if I read it?
Suit yourself.
Oh, that gift. Is that for your father?
Yeah.
I'm sure he'll treasure it.
It's nothing.
He wasn't scared. He knew the thief.
Did he ID him?
Yes, he just didn't intend to.
No! I told you everything I know.
I just have a few more questions, okay? Come on. Yeah, let's go.
Hey, what do we look like, rats?
Don't push me.
Thank you very much.
Right. Okay. Thanks.
Parole officer says Porter's been a model citizen. Worked as a janitor the past 6 years. No complaints, never missed a day's work. You got that, Elaine?
Got it.
He'd come home, he'd take care of his kid, then he'd spend half the night writing short stories. Something he picked up in prison, I guess.
And the boy's mother?
Left him with an aunt about 8 years ago and did a bunk. When Porter got out, he took the kid back.
William Sidney Porter pled guilty to 1 count of armed robbery. He was the driver. Served 7 years, released on good behavior. Nothing since.
Doesn't make any sense. Why would he leave his son?
Fraser, this may come as a shock to you, but here in the United States of America, we've discovered that bank robbers aren't usually the best family men.
He leaves prison. He reclaims his son. He works 6 years at a minimum wage job.
27, Elaine Vesperus.
This isn't a man who would abandon his life without an awful lot of thought. When the Donnellys found out he'd betrayed them, his son would have been the natural target. I don't think he'd have left him behind unprotected.
Maybe he acted on impulse.
No, I think he has a plan. We just don't know what it is.
Thanks. Porter's passport expired last month. No request for renewal.
So where's he planning to go? I brought the wiretap request over in person, sir, but his honor had consumed a great deal of Christmas cheer and started cursing at me in Norwegian. I wasn't aware that he spoke it either, sir.
I appreciate that. Right. Did you have to bring him?
Well, it is Christmas Eve, Ray.
What are you reading?
My father's journals. I'm just going over old cases to see if there's anything similar.
Is there?
Not that I found.
What is it?
I just wish I'd spent more time with him. There's a lot of things I should have learned.
I learned two things from my father. One, timing. Mostly when to duck. And two, you never hit a kid, because it doesn't teach him anything. I'm gonna go to the gas station. I'll be right back.
Sam Dalton made only one mistake. He planned everything but how he was going to spend the money. Before he'd hit Whitehorse, he'd left a trail of 20s that took me right to his door. But Sam's case was nothing like this.
No, I know, but what I can't seem to find is...
Hello, son.
Hello, Dad. How are you?
I'm dead, son. Other than that, do you mean?
No, that's what I was asking.
Well, let's go. Never be ashamed to ask a stupid question, son. I taught you that, didn't I?
Not specifically, no.
Well, no time like the present. So fill me in on the case.
The case?
The case. The case you're working on. Something bothers you about it.
Well, in a nutshell, there was a bank robbery today. Now, we've identified the perpetrators, but the Wheelman, that's the driver in Chicago parlance, double-crosses partners. Now, what we can't seem to figure, is there any insanity in our family?
No, not that I'm aware of.
Good.
Well, there was your Uncle Tiberius who died wrapped in cabbage leaves, but we assume that was a freak accident. Go on, go on.
Oh, you took your time, Robert. Doing a little Christmas shopping, I see.
Check this. Porter had a second car parked in an alley about a block away.
Really? Cameron, have to apologize to you. Seems Porter isn't planning on sharing after all.
Apology accepted, James.
Oh, Robert, I meant to ask you. Why did you toss Porter the bag?
I was trapped behind the counter, man. The cops were coming.
So instead of running around the counter, you threw the bag and jumped over?
Yeah.
Well, it makes sense.
I was thinking of getting out of there with the cash, you know?
But you didn't, did you? You're the bagman, Robert. You're supposed to carry the bag.
Hey, Jimmy, come on, man. He threw me the gun. I mean, the alarms were going off.
No, I understand. Everyone gets to make one mistake. And that was yours. See what he got us.
Fireside calendars.
Oh, I love those. Now, let's see what young Dell got. So did you just happen to pick this moment to reappear?
Well, obviously, you needed my help, son. And it was my fault. But I better prepared you. You wouldn't be floundering around like this.
Well, I'm not completely over my head, Dad. I mean, I...
No. Don't try to make me feel better, son. I failed you as a father, but I'm going to make that up to you now.
How exactly do you propose to do that, Dad? I mean, it's not as...
Anything happened?
In what sense?
There's a light up there. And it's condemned. Stay.
Me?
Him.
Bender. Oh. See how fast he noticed that? Observation is everything, son.
Thank you, Dad.
Out back.
There.
Police, freeze!
Count to three and rise up together, shooting.
I don't carry a weapon.
You what?
I don't carry a weapon.
Is that smart, son?
It's the law, Dad.
No, Well, no time for niceties. Here, use mine.
Well, I appreciate the offer, but it's imaginary.
Oh, so it is.
It's my last clip. They're maneuvering for position.
I can see that.
See what?
They're maneuvering for position.
I can see that.
You've only got a few seconds left.
Right again.
About what?
You've only got a few seconds left.
What you need, son, if you don't mind me saying, is a good, solid plan. Or you could just throw a rock.
Fire your entire clip on three.
Then he'll be out of bullets.
Then I'll be out of bullets.
I heard both of you.
Is there an entire conversation going on here that I'm totally unaware of?
Yes. One, two, three.
At least you found the villain, son. There's something to be said for that.
Thank you.
Anytime.
We know your father did it. We know he has the money, and we know that you know where he is. What we don't know is how smart you are.
I can't help you.
Now we know. Benny, talk to him. Ask him if you noticed the men with guns who were coming after him. Your father left you hanging, kid. Maybe you should stop worrying about him and start worrying about yourself. Tell him that, Benny.
I will, Ray.
Yeah, you do that.
Oh, man, you believe this?
I said elves, you morons! Elves!
Del, I know you want to help your father. You wouldn't be much of a son if you didn't.
The only way to protect him is if we can bring him in off the streets. Now, it took us several hours to identify your father, during which time he could have easily left town, but he didn't.
You don't know that.
Yes, I do. He wouldn't leave you. And yet, he didn't get you out of town before the robbery or arrange to meet you someplace else. Now, why is that?
Well, maybe his plans just didn't include me at all.
Well, I don't believe that. And I don't think you do either.
Think again.
Talk to him?
Yes.
Look, kid. We ought to get the best fathers, and yours, well, he ain't gonna win any parenting awards, but he's all you got, so you gonna help him or what?
He's gone by now.
And you can go. Just check out at the front desk before you leave.
We can't just let him go back out there.
All right, keep a close eye on him. If you're right, his father will try to contact him again.
We're gonna use him as bait?
Something we'd like to do every Christmas.
Don't lose them. And don't let the Donnellys get them.
Oh, I gotta call my ma and tell her why I'm gonna be late. Meet you out back.
I never taught you how to interrogate a witness, son.
I know.
The seven ways to tell if a man is lying.
Well, I kind of pieced it together for myself.
Oh, good. So you know what to watch for in their eyes?
Yes.
You know if they look up and to the right, they're lying.
Uh-huh.
Unless they're aware of that, in which case they try to look straight at you.
Yeah.
Or they overcompensate and end up looking down and to the left.
Oh, really? Would you mind waiting here? I'll be right back.
Drive, quick, before he comes back.
Who?
My father. Drive, go.
Fraser, your father's dead.
I know, and I don't mean to speak ill of him. It's just he's driving me nuts.
Your father?
He's not really here. I know that. It's all in my mind. It's just he refuses to stay there, or rather, he refuses to leave there. I don't really understand it, but I'll tell you, it's beginning to wear a little thin. I mean, does he think I'm completely ignorant? I mean, I don't know. The next thing he's going to do is try to show me how to start a fire. You know, Ray, I got half a mind just to tell him to pack up, move out.
Of your mind?
Yes.
Hello, son?
Oh, God, he's back.
What's that?
I said, glad you're back, Dad. Not a word, all right?
Hey, no problem, Benny.
That's him!
Who?
What?
There.
Where? Right in front of the police station? Now, that is cheap.
can't hear any excuses.
You just listen to me. If something happens to me, I gotta know.
Dad, I don't wanna hear this.
If something happens to me, you gotta know where I hid the money.
I don't want the damn money.
I don't care what you want.
Now there is a surprise, huh?
Just listen to me. I don't know how this thing is gonna turn out.
Dad, you said you were finished. You know, you promised
Del,
me.
Del, I didn't want to do this. Just listen. Just listen to me. If something happens to me, I gotta know that you're okay.
That I'm okay, huh? Now you think of this?
Don't talk to me that way. I'm your father.
You're a loser. That's what you are. You couldn't make one damn thing work up for yourself. Not one. So why should I listen to one thing you have to say?
Del!
You won't get away with it. I know you must have a plan, but there's no way it'll work.
There's a man who loves his work.
I don't think so, Ray.
Are you sure you don't want something?
No, thanks, son, I couldn't. Well, this is the first real Christmas dinner we've had together in 20 years, and I'm not even really here.
Aren't you?
I don't know any more about this than you do, son. Am I here? Am I in your head? You in mine? Damned if I can figure it out.
Well, finally, something you don't understand.
Well, there's lots of things that I don't understand, Benton. How I lived all those years and didn't get to know my son.
You know, I should be able to see his plan. I mean, there aren't that many variables. But no matter which way I twist it, I can't seem to see how he thinks he'd get away with it. I mean, you don't double-cross your partners and then stay around town. You don't plan a getaway and forget about your son. Unless you don't plan on getting away with it.
How do you mean?
It's the only thing that explains his actions.
I don't follow you.
No one would plan a double cross this intricate and leave the getaway to chance. He did plan it through. He knew exactly what he was doing, and he is not planning on getting away with it.
But nobody plans to fail, son. It doesn't make sense.
If it's the only logical solution, it doesn't have to make sense.
What the hell does that mean?
Don't you see it?
No.
Well, of course you do. It's obvious.
I don't.
Really?
Oh.
You don't?
Oh.
Oh.
But you do. Go bring him in, son. That's what I taught you.
Anything happened?
In what sense?
Is Dale still in there?
Yeah.
24 hours and you still haven't solved the case.
Come on, Dad, it's Christmas Day. You want to give it a rest?
Hey, you don't care about your work? It's fine with me.
First time we went to prison, I was 6 years old. I actually thought it was my fault. I thought if I didn't ask him for all those things kids ask their fathers for, you know, like bikes and toys or whatever, that he wouldn't go out and steal to get them for me. When he got out, I was so careful not to ask him for anything, because I thought that if I did, he'd go out and do something like this again. You know, all I ever wanted was to have him here with me. But it didn't matter what I wanted, did it? He didn't give a damn about me. He didn't even tell me about this. He just went out and did it. Well, you know what? This isn't my fault. And he's not my responsibility. He can go back to jail. He can go to hell for all I care.
Oh, he isn't going back to prison, Del. That's not his plan at all. He's gonna let you know where the money is. Then he'll kill the Donnellys. Then he'll kill himself. He'll make it look as though the money was destroyed. You'll get it all. He's planning to die. And he's doing this for you.
You know when I was most proud of him? What do you want me to do?
Let's go.
Which of them should go and turn robber all on the salt sea?
Distillery, something closed down or abandoned.
The lot it fell first upon Henry Martin, the youngest of all of the three, that he should turn robber all on the salt sea, the salt sea, the salt sea. To maintain his two brothers and he. They have not been sailing for a long winter's night, nor part of a short winter's day. When they did aspire, stout lofty ship,
lofty ship, lofty ship. Her parents' distillery closed down about 10 years ago, Southside.
Call a
thank you kindly, Elaine.
Hello, hello, cried Henry Martin. What makes you sail so nigh? I'm a rich merchant ship bound for fair London town, London town, London town. Wouldn't you please for to let us pass by?
Hello. I'm here.
Well, you're a man of your word, William. Good show. Bring me that big gun I like. I almost never get to use it.
For I have turned rubber all on the salt sea, the salt sea, the salt sea. For to maintain my two brothers on the sea. So lower your topsail and fire up your mission. Bring your ship under my lee. For I have resolved for to pirate you here, here, oh dear. For to maintain my two brothers and me.
Okay, you got 2 minutes, then I'm in there.
So broadside for broadside, and at it they went. For fully 2 hours or three. Martin gave to them the death shot, the death shot, the death shot. And straight to the bottom went she.
You're one unlucky Canadian.
I'd be careful if I were you. I think you're standing in a pool of gasoline.
I'm not interested in killing you. If you want to walk, I'll let you.
I can't do that. You know, it took me a while to figure out what you were doing. One doesn't ordinarily equate crime with self-sacrifice.
I guess I'm going to have to take my offer back.
You went straight, William. A long time, 6 years.
I love how people like you think that earning $4 an hour is great and noble. I couldn't afford to buy my kid a Christmas gift. That's not noble. It's pathetic.
I don't think your son would have seen it that way.
You know what my son saw? He saw a sap that worked 12 hours a day at a job he hated and then came home and worked another 6 hours at a job that nobody wanted to pay him for. The only thing I ever showed my kid was how to be a loser.
And you thought robbing a bank would win his respect?
Respect? Oh, I haven't thought about that in a long time. All I wanted was $3. $3 for the whole year, and I'd have made it. I was standing there at the counter with his gift in my hand. Girl says to me, you're $3 short. I started laughing. I laughed so hard, I thought I was gonna have a heart attack right there in that department store. I suddenly realized that if I died right then and there, I'd have left my son $62, some lousy manuscripts, and a lot of excuses. And that's not good enough. That's not enough to leave your son.
You know, William, I think there's only one thing that a father needs to leave his son. And that's a good example of how a man should live his life. Anything else, the son can learn for himself. The greatest gift my father ever gave me was the courage to trust my own abilities. And I learned that through his example. You know, you can give your son anything you want, but if you don't leave him a good example of how to be a man, you leave him nothing. That's what you'll leave Dell. Nothing.
Put the lighter away, William. You don't want to do this.
You stay put!
Nobody has to die here.
Now look at this, Cameron. It's a Christmas party.
Drop the guns!
Stuff it. Jimmy? Now you weren't being totally frank with us, were you, William?
You want to kill me, Jimmy? You want to do that? Go ahead.
Said I got you last Christmas was obviously a mistake.
You can't get away with this!
Actually, you can, Ray. Everyone involved in the robbery will die, so his son is safe from retribution. There's enough cash in that bag to convince the forensic experts that the money was destroyed in the blaze. The police will stop looking for it. All he has to do is drop that bottle. He gets away with it.
Thanks for backing me up on this one, Benny.
Sorry, Ray. It's your decision, William. Do you leave something for your son, or do you steal from him?
Drop it.
Drop it!
Not you, you moron!
Sorry.
Hi. Looks like I screwed up our Christmas plans.
Yeah. It's okay.
U.S. attorneys agreed to 3 to 5.
That's good.
You'll be a man before I get out.
I'll be all right. Aunt Celia's cool about it, you know.
I'm sorry, Del. I'm really sorry.
I got you something, Dad.
beautiful. Must have cost you a fortune. I used to have one just like this. You were six then. How do you remember that?
I used to watch you write. You know, I think, that's my dad.
I didn't get you anything, son.
Yes, you did.
You know, I think you're wrong about Sam Dalton. Cases weren't entirely dissimilar. Dad? You still here?
Merry Christmas, son. Merry Christmas.
High winds, northern sky will carry you away. You know you have to leave here. Wish that you could stay. It's four directions on this map, but you're only going one way.